Hello everyone, this is Science Vines and you're watching the audiovisual chapter of class 11th biology. This is the first part of chapter 22, chemical coordination and integration. You have already learned that the neural system provides a point-to-point rapid coordination among organs. The neural coordination is fast but short-lived. As the nerve fibers do not innervate all cells of the body and the cellular functions need to be continuously regulated, a special kind of a coordination and integration has to be provided. This function is carried out by hormones. The neural system and the endocrine system jointly coordinate and regulate the physiological functions in the body. Endocrine glands and hormones. Endocrine glands lack ducts and are hence called ductless glands. Their secretions are called hormones. The classical definition of a hormone as a chemical produced by endocrine glands and released into blood and transported to a distantly located target organ has current scientific definition as follows. Hormones are non-nutrient chemicals which act as intercellular messengers and are produced in trace amounts. The new definition covers the number of new molecules in addition to the hormones secreted by the organized endocrine glands. Invertebrates possess a very simple endocrine system with few hormones, whereas a large number of chemicals act as hormones and provide coordination in the vertebrates. The human endocrine system is described here. The human endocrine system. The endocrine glands and hormone producing diffuse tissues or cells located in different parts of our body constitute the endocrine system. Pituitary, pineal, thyroid, adrenal, pancreas, parathyroid, thymus and gonads, testes in males and ovary in females, are organized endocrine bodies in our body. In addition to these, some other organs, example, gastrointestinal tract, liver, kidney, heart also produce hormones. A brief account of the structure and functions of all major endocrine glands and hypothalamus of the human body is given in the following sections. The hypothalamus. As you know, the hypothalamus is the basal part of diencephalon, forebrain, and it regulates a wide spectrum of body functions. It contains several groups of neurosecretory cells called nuclei, which produce hormones. These hormones regulate the synthesis and secretion of pituitary hormones. However, the hormones produced by the hypothalamus are of two types. The releasing hormone, which stimulates secretion of pituitary hormones, and the inhibiting hormone, which inhibits secretions of pituitary hormone. For example, a hypothalamic hormone called gonadotropin-releasing hormone, GnRH, stimulates the pituitary synthesis and release of gonadotropins. On the other hand, somatostatin from the hypothalamus inhibits the release of growth hormone from the pituitary. These hormones originating in the hypothalamic neurons pass through axons and are released from their nerve endings. These hormones reach the pituitary gland through a portal circulatory system and regulate the functions of the anterior pituitary. The posterior pituitary is under the direct neural regulation of the hypothalamus. The pituitary gland. The pituitary gland is located in a bony cavity called cella turcica and is attached to the hypothalamus by a stalk. It is divided anatomically into an adenohypophysis and a neurohypophysis. Adenohypophysis consists of two portions, pars distalis and pars intermedia. The pars distalis region of pituitary, commonly called anterior pituitary, produces growth hormone GH, prolactin PRL, thyroid stimulating hormone TSH, adrenocorticotrophic hormone ACTH, luteinizing hormone LH, and follicle-stimulating hormone, FSH. Pars intermedia secretes only one hormone called melanocyte-stimulating hormone, MSH. However, in humans, the pars intermedia is almost merged with pars distalis. Neurohypophysis, pars nervosa, also known as posterior pituitary, stores and releases two hormones called oxytocin and vasopressin, which are actually synthesized by the hypothalamus and are transported axonally two neurohypophyses. Over-secretion of a GH stimulates abnormal growth of the body, leading to gigantism, and lower secretion of a GH results in stunted growth, resulting in pituitary dwarfism. Excess secretion of a growth hormone in adults, especially in middle age, can result in severe disfigurement, especially of the face, called acromegaly, which may lead to serious complications and premature death if unchecked. The disease is hard to diagnose in the early stages and often goes undetected for many years, until changes in external features become noticeable. Prolactin regulates the growth of the mammary glands and formation of milk in them. TSH stimulates the synthesis and secretion of a thyroid hormones from the thyroid gland. ACTH stimulates the synthesis and secretion of steroid hormones called glucocorticoids from the adrenal cortex. LH and FSH stimulate gonadal activity and hence are called gonadotrophins. In males, LH stimulates the synthesis and secretion of a hormone called androgens from testes. In males, FSH and androgens regulate spermatogenesis. In females, LH induces ovulation of fully mature follicles, graafian follicles, and maintains the corpus luteum formed from the remnants of the graafian follicles. After ovulation, FSH stimulate growth and development of the ovarian follicles in the female. MSH acts on the melanocytes, melanin-containing cells, and regulate pigmentation of the skin. Oxytocin acts on the smooth muscles of our body and stimulates their contraction. In females, it stimulates a vigorous contraction of uterus at the time of childbirth and milk ejection from the mammary gland. Vasopressin acts mainly at the kidney and stimulates resorption of water and electrolytes by the distal tubules and thereby reduces loss of water through the urine diuresis. Hence, it is called as antidiuretic hormone, ADH. An impairment affecting synthesis of release of ADH result in a diminished ability of the kidney to conserve water, leading to water loss and dehydration. This condition is known as diabetes insipidus. The pineal gland. The pineal gland is located on the dorsal side of the forebrain. Pineal secretes a hormone called melatonin. Melatonin plays a very important role in the regulation of 24-hour rhythm of our body, or we call it as a circadian rhythm cycle. For example, it helps in maintaining the normal rhythms of sleep-wake cycle, body temperature. In addition, melatonin also influences metabolism, pigmentation, the menstrual cycle, as well as our defense capability. Thyroid gland. The thyroid gland is composed of two lobes, which are located on either side of the trachea. Both the lobes are interconnected with a thin flap of connective tissue called isthmus. The thyroid gland is composed of follicles and stromal tissues. Each thyroid follicle is composed of follicular cells, enclosing a cavity. These follicular cells synthesize two hormones, tetraiodothyronine or thyroxine T4 and triiodothyronine T3. Iodine is essential for the normal rate of hormone synthesis in the thyroid. Deficiency of iodine in our diet results in hypothyroidism and enlargement of the thyroid gland, commonly called goiter. Hypothyroidism during pregnancy causes defective development and maturation of the growing baby, leading to stunted growth, cretinism, mental retardation, low intelligence quotient, abnormal skin, deaf mutism, etc. In adult women, hypothyroidism may cause menstrual cycle to become irregular. Due to cancer of the thyroid gland or due to development of nodules of the thyroid glands, the rate of synthesis and secretion of the thyroid hormone is increased to abnormal high levels, leading to a condition called hyperthyroidism, which adversely affects the body physiology. Exothalamic goiter is a form of hyperthyroidism, characterized by enlargement of the thyroid gland, protrusion of the eyeballs, increased basal metabolic rate, and weight loss, also called Graves' disease. Thyroid hormones play an important role in the regulation of the basal metabolic rate. These hormones also support the process of red blood cell formation. Thyroid hormones control the metabolism of carbohydrates, proteins, and fats. Maintenance of water and electrolyte balance is also influenced by the thyroid hormones. Thyroid gland also secretes a protein hormone called thyrocalcitonin, TCT, which regulates the blood calcium level. Here we end the first part of the chapter 21, Chemical Coordination and Integration. To watch more such videos, do subscribe the channel and press the bell icon so you don't miss any video. And if you want us to create more such videos on any other book or subject, do mention in the comment section please. Like and share the video to keep us motivated and to create such content. Thank you for watching the video. Bye bye. Love.